Hello and welcome to the Akaran Sector. This is Andrew and this is 550 points of Orcs again versus 550 points of Sisters. Welcome to the planet of Our Lady's Grace. This is the home planet of the Sisters of Battle, which I now have a name. They are the Order of the Patient Lady, and they also, this is the home world for our knights as well. But disaster has struck. A small asteroid touched down with a big boom, and some greenskins, some orcs came crawling out. Yes, I know the last game was Orcs, but I had a lot of fun, and I still need to learn more about the Sisters, so that's what we're going to do today. So the Orc list hasn't changed, but the Sisters list has shifted up a bit. We'll go look at that, but we're also playing Open War, and here's today's cards. So we've got Search and Seek Secure again, so the Orcs are looking for something, looking for some shiny gubbins. So the objective markers, we'll look at them in a second, will start disappearing, and you score 1 point for everyone you hold each turn. Deployment zone is pretty interesting. It's pretty tight on a smaller table. The deployment zone is this oblong here, but there's space to move out. And then there's just about 5 inches on the edge here. So it should be for an interesting matchup. So I don't know who's playing on what side yet. I rolled on a 1-2-3, this side would be the oblong, and then a 4-5-6 with that side, so I rolled a 3. And then my twist, draw 2 more, which we got. So all auras are -2 inches, which is going to affect the Sisters because they kind of rely on auras. And then tempest, so if you're more than 80 inches away, you get the benefit of light cover for being shot at, which I'm going to let stack if you already are in terrain, so you're going to get 2 up on that one. So we'll see how that plays out. So that could hinder the Sisters for a little if they get first turn and are shooting at orcs. But then there's this big line of sight blocking terrain. All the rubble is, and these are -2 to move over. Light cover in the buildings. Light cover and -1's a hit in the industrial terrain. So I think that about covers everything. Let's go look at the armies. Again, 550 points of orcs. Death skulls again, and I must remember that to do all the rerolls, they can do 1 hit roll, 1 wound roll, and 1 damage roll for each unit, apart from these guys. So Tiny here, the warlord again. Ed Splitter himself, I paid 1 command point for the biggest boss to give him 1 more wound, 1 more attack, 4 up invul. Combi Scorcher, his warlord trait is Mighty's Right. So again, he's 1+1 attack, +1 strength. So he's got lots of attacks and lots of strength. And his relic is the Killer Claw. So again, reroll failed wound rolls. He'll be running on 2s. Flat 3 damage, AP -3. Weird Boy, I've not paid for an extra relic. I don't think it worked out too well last time. He's got the jump again. We've got the mixture of boys in the troops. Actually, after the last game, I did go and get some more boys, so they will be split into a chopper boys and a shooter boys list. But for now, big chopper on the knob, rocket, mixture of shooters and choppers, WYSIWYG, Gretchen, either backfield objective holders or food. Knob with War Banner again, and his custom shooter knobs, bringing up the last for the elite. And they have Kill Saw, 2 Power Claws, and 2 Big Choppers in and amongst them. So that's the Orcs. Let's go and look at the slightly jigged up Sisters list. And we have about 540 points of Sisters, led by a brand new Canoness, painted up by Sultan from the UK for me. And she is an old, wizened canoness. She hasn't got a name yet. I must find a name for her. She is the advisor to the younger canoness, who's the full warlord for this troop. She doesn't like taking the spotlight too much, but when she has to, she will. She has the Blessed Blade and Beacon of Faith. And of course, these are running again as Valorous Heart. So ignore AP minus one, ignore AP minus two. Now we need 4 inches in front of, within range of that one. She has Beacon of Faith, so she's going to get extra miracle dice. And I changed to Relic, Wrath of the Emperor, which is a 18-inch pistol 4, strength 5, AP minus 2, 2 damage weapon. That's pretty brutal. But no extra command points spent yet. One Sisters group, Combi Melter, Melter. Combi Flamer, Flamer, Heavy Flamer, Simulcrum. Combi Melter, Heavy Bolter, Flamer, Simulcrum. So yeah, just a lot of Sisters shots. Then the Dominions, with all with Flamers and Combi Melter Power Sword. And then the Seraphim, hopefully doing more work this time to come in. So there's Pistol Power Sword, and then 2 Inferno Pistols, which I guess don't really need it for Orcs, but I'm trying to keep things WYSIWYG. So that's that. We will go set up the roll off and see who's attacker defender, and then come back after they've all been deployed. So to deployment over with, the Orcs won the roll-off and chose to be, I guess, defender on this side. They're kind of marching in a column, that's very much an Orc-like, but the Gretchen are way at the back, they can come take this objective, they can come take this objective, although the knob with the war banner, after the last game, decided, yeah, he likes out the way. The knobs are here with the war boss to charge forward, so they can charge and advance with the war boss nearby, as long as they're in 4 inches now. The weird boy is well away from the warlord this time. Not going to dad jump him this time. We might jump the boys, get them in range somewhere. The sisters have just made a firing line. The Seraphim are in reserve, but that's the Combi Melter Melter, the Flamer, Combi Flamer, Flamer, Heavy Flamer, with the Imagifier and the Canoness. The Dominion's ready to run forward and take that objective, and they will do so before the first turn. And then the Heavy Bolter, Flamer, Combi Melter are there to, you know, push forward and surge forward and see what happens. And the Seraphim will come and take objective later in the game. So the minute, only the Orcs are actually on an objective. But now we need to roll off to see who gets first turn. Green for the Orcs, of course. And the Sisters will go first. So you're going to turn one for the Sisters of Battle. One thing I did forget to mention, there's the extra benefit these girls get. You can either roll 2 dice and choose them, or choose one yourself. So today I've chose, every time a model dies on a 5-up, they can make a shooting attack or a close combat attack, and we'll do that with these girls because the other ones don't seem to have much benefit. So they made the pre-game move but then didn't move after that, so they're holding the objective under there. These girls advanced because they can't shoot anything. The Simulcrum, the Imagifier advanced, so she's within 4 inches of 2 units now. Canoness is there. And actually, the only unit that can shoot turn one is these girls over here, putting shots down range somewhere. So we will go on to the shooting phase. And I remember I must put my miracle dice down where I remember to use them. 2 ones. So one for the start of the turn, and one for the start of the, because of my warlord trait. So that's not particularly useful, but it might come in handy later. So the 4 bolt guns are in range of the knobs here. You will get cover because they're in the rubble. Hitting on 3s. Wounding on 4s. And that is the end of Turn one for the Sisters of Battle. That was very quick. So at the end of the turn, they do control two objectives. So they have 2 points. And we'll now go into Orcs turn one. End of the Orc movement phase. The Nobs advanced a mighty 2, which meant they only moved 5, come out of cover. And they're not in charge range, so they're going to get shot at. But the war banner and the bosses behind them, screaming at them, do more. And Boys didn't move, because he moved to take that objective, and he'll try and to jump them. So he'll go off on a 6, because he's got the plus 1 to cast, having more than 10 boys nearby. And the Gretchen advanced a mighty 6 to take that objective, because they don't want to be in the fight. And it's also a bit of screening, because the war boss saw that there were some tiny beakies with some jumpy bits. And he shouted, go over there, we don't want the jumpy bits. So we will go on to the psychic phase, and we'll try and jump the boys on a 6. That goes off. Outside of any kind of roll to stop that. We'll come back in a second. And suddenly the weird boy feels a lot better, as there is nobody anywhere near him. So he can have a nice peaceful existence watching this objective. And 12 or 13 boys dropped in here. They are 9-inch charge away from this one, this one, this one, or that one. So they can have a bit of a pick. So what we're going to do is when I... So what we've done, we're paying two CP for more DACA on these guys, so they explode on 5 and 6s. And there is 5 sluggers, 6 shooters, and the rocket. And they all hit on 5s, they didn't actually advance. So we'll do the rocket first. And we're all shooting everything at the ladies here that flame. That does not hit. You don't want the burny ones. Don't like the burny ones. Let's have a look. Two, 4, 6. Any more? Oh, we can invent another 2. Strength 4, toughness 3, 3s. And then the behind the barrier, so they're saving on 2s. And we managed to save everything. So that is the end of the Orc shooting phase. So they've got to decide who to charge, because there's probably a lot of Overwatch coming at them, whoever they do decide to charge. Flamer. Although if they charge these ones, they take them off the objective because their objective secured, because they're troops. Can't the Orcs be that clever? Yeah, we've got to try this one. So we will spend the command point for Overwatch. And first of all, do they get in? So they need 9. Oh yes, they're in. So there is 4 flamers, the bolter, and the melter. So the melter hits, the bolter does not hit, and then we roll 1 range of the melter, and then these can save. I completely forgot the rerolls. So the rocket, nope, and that was a wound roll, nope. No, they were everything wounded, didn't they? Never mind. Ha. Right. So that saves on a 6. Nope. So, right, the rocket guy can go first. Auto hits from the flamers. 10, 12. 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. Wounding on 4s. Two, 4, 6. Saving on sixes. Ooh, the orcs are not having it. So only two of them go. So we're going to take away a couple of the shooters from over that way. I'll move them in and we'll do some combat. We have a bunch of attacks coming in at hitting on threes, wounding on threes, and saving on threes. And then we have these ones that are strength plus two. So that's the big chopper from the boss knob. So he'll hit on threes, wound on twos. But because it's AP minus one, they will still ignore that and save on threes. But we'll see how many of these sisters can be taken down. Starting with the big chopper. And I can reroll one because I'm lucky. And then wounding on twos. And we'll save that on threes. And then a six up, feel no pain. Nope. So that's one attack back later on. Many, many lots plus one attacks coming through. There we go. Hitting on threes. Some filled ones. Wounding on threes because it's strength five, toughness three. And then 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Saving on threes. And then sixes. Alright, so we've got two of them fall. Can they make an attack back on a five? Nope. So two flamers go. So there are two. And then the superior gets two with her power sword. So these will hit on fours and wound on fives. And the power sword will hit on fours and wound on fours. And that'll save on a six. And the orc saves it. Oh, the orcs are doing lucky today. And they've taken this objective off the sisters. So these orcs need to be dealt with. Oh, and these two ladies who have taken away. So at the end of turn one for the orcs, they get 1, 2, 3 points. So that's 3 points to two in favour of the orcs and their dead pile. So now we will go on to turn two. Can the sisters repel the orcs and take back their home planet before it goes into a new war? So end of turn one. There's kind of no good place around here to drop in the Seraphim, so they've stayed off. They'll probably go hunting a weird boy a bit later. Unless he dad jumps himself somewhere useful. These have moved forward. We're still on that objective for now. And these are going to try and get rid of the knobs. And then there's the Canoness, the Imagifier, and the Flamer Heavy Bolter Squad. We'll try and get clear out these guys here. And then if not in close combat with the Canoness, that was probably a foolish idea. But the Flamers and the Melters are now all ranging the knobs there. And I guess the Seraphim might have to come back. Oh! Actually, before we do, we need to roll off which objective. Objective 6. Ah, oh, that one's that one there. That's okay. So objective 6 has gone off the battlefield. So nobody's losing out any points just yet. So we'll go on to the shooting phase. I will put her pistol, heavy 4, hitting on 2s. Rerolling 1s because she's the Canoness. Strength 5, so wounding on 3s. And saving on 6s. Nope. So 3 boys are taken out. Are they lost? Maybe they should have done a morale test last turn, but I'm not too worried about that now. The Imagifier hitting on threes, wounding on fours. One wound, saving on a six. That's saved. Right, these girls. So there's a heavy bolter, a flamer, two bolt guns, and a combi bolter and melter. So we will fire them, so they'll hit on fours. So we'll... How are we going to do? We'll start this end then. So the melter hits on a four. Hits. Definitely wounds. Saves on a six because they've got an invul. And at this range, yeah, that's going to do enough damage. The bolter hits on a four. Two hits. Wounds on a four. Saves on a six. Nope. So one more goes there. Heavy bolter hits on threes, wounds on threes, saves on sixes. Should have done this one last, really, because the knob has two wounds. One, two. And then the two bolters, all hits, wound on fours, three wounds. All right. We need to make it one on six to save. Nope. We do our job. We clear away the boys. There is no endless green tide coming. We secure this objective. So this group here will fire into the knobs first. So there is a combi melter hitting on a four, wounding on a two, saving on a six. That's saved. Two bolter, or the combi bolter hitting on fours, wounding on fours, saving on a six. These knobs are not doing it. A melter doesn't hit. Bolters. Four hits, wounding on fours. And that's three saves. And these still have their cyborg body, so they get five up, feel no pain. And they pass all of those. So then it's onto the flamer, combi flamer, flamer, heavy flamer, two bolters. So we will do, we can do the flamers together. These bolters hit on fours, wound on fours, save on a six. These knobs do not want to move. And these bolters, four hits, wound on fours, just two wounds, saving on sixes, then fives and six, and then fives and six. We finally kill a single knob. I'm hoping the codex these get three wounds. So we'll take him away. Two flamers, four, eight, five. Wounding on fours. Saving on sixes. Then, nope. You get down one more orc. Where's the other chopper? There he is. And then a single heavy flamer. Two hits. Wounding on threes. Still saving on sixes, and then a five or a six. We only, after all that firepower, we take down two. That counter charge is going to be insane. So they... Do they need to take a leadership test? They lost two. Leadership seven. I guess they can fail it on a six. No. So they are fine. So So that was a very good phase from the sisters. No need to charge anything. Orcs have some thinking to do. This is, so we get 2 points, so putting us on to 3 points to 4 for the sisters. And we will go on to the Orcs phase, and they will do some crumping. And I don't know what he should do something, I suppose. All right. So end of the movement phase. Back here, nothing changed. And this little bunch of knobs have decided maybe if they pick on that one first, and then they can consolidate into that one, and maybe not go flamery death. They might get melted to death, but you know. And the war boss and the war banner are there, so there's going to be lots of charging. But first, some shooting. Oh no, psychic phase. I don't think there's anything he can do. He can jump onto that one, but that's the same as holding that one. So I have to wait to see if one of their objectives disappears. Maybe this one will disappear. We'll find out. So we'll do some shooting. So we will put everything from there into them. So he has a shooter and a scorcher. Let's try and get rid of some of these flamey girls. Hitting on sixes. And daka. Oh, wow, two hits. Wounding on threes. Saving on threes. And a six. Nope. And then on a five, she can shoot back. Nope. So just the bolter lady can go. But lay that down in case there's morale. And then the scorcher gets one. Wounds on a three. Doesn't wound. Next, we put the three shooters from. There's the assault four from the banner. He did advance, so that only hit on sixes as well. And then three shots from the knobs that didn't advance, all into the flaming sisters as well. Hits on fives. Threes. Well, we got one of them. That's something. So we will go on to the charge phase, and we'll only charge these ones here with the knobs first, and we will pay obligatory command point for Overwatch. So there is Melter Combi Melter, and 1, 2, 3 bolters and a Melter. Right, the two Melter shots, nothing, and the bolter shots, nothing. And the knobs, big 12. So they will come round this way. The war banner, I can reroll because I'm an orc. That might have scuppered me. Nope. Just. And then the boss knob. Reroll. Yeah, he's in. And he will actually tag them on his way in. That's fine. They're not going to do a lot of damage back. They can't attack them, so that sister can come off. They're not going to fill morale. But they can maybe do some bets to the war boss. Right. Dice game. So the orcs have found their happy place. So there is 3 attacks for the Killsaw, 6 Power Claw, and then the war banner. He has 4 attacks. Will do him first. He hits on threes. And then wound on threes. And these will save on threes. And then a 6 up, feel no pain. Nope. Then a 5 or 6, she can attack back. Nope. So we'll just get rid of one of the bolters. And the war boss gets 6 attacks, but we'll do him. Yeah, we'll do the war boss first. Hits on twos. Crumps on twos, and he can re-roll any failed wounds. And 4, 6 up saves. And These are 3 damage each. One's dead. 2's dead. 3's dead. Ah, that's the squad. The war boss pretty much did it on his own. So the knobs are now looking slightly angry because they wanted to do it. So we'll take them off. So now we're not on that objective. And we can't consolidate onto the objective because the nearest enemy is that way. But these girls can consolidate into the war boss. So the superior gets 3 attacks, so she's got chainsword. And then there's 3 other girls. Oh no, wait, the 4 there on 5, so they can attack back. So one attacks back, she hits the knobs, hits, wounds, saves. So then the girls attack, hitting the war boss on 4s. And he is toughness 5, so they're wounding on 5s. Well, they should be wounding on 5s anyway, because they're strength 3, aren't they? Oh, never mind. Well, they didn't do any damage anyway. So, at the end of the orc's turn 2, we get 2 points for over here, so 5 points to 4. The sisters have some work to do to get rid of the orcs in their lines here. The knobs and the war banners are free to shoot. I guess the seraphim need to come into a get where they can get the war boss because they've got the melters. But he's got Thorabinvol. Oh, this is going to be a challenging one. Turn 3 for the sisters of battle. So first we'll see which objective is removed. Number 2, which is that one. Oh, the sisters might not be scoring any points this turn. The seraphim drops in here and we'll pay the command point. I'll check what the stratagem's called in a minute. So they'll be in range of him. They pulled out. Her pistol's in range. The flamers advanced, so they're in range. Everything here is in range. So we have to kill the war boss. And then we can deal with the rest after that. So I'll go check the stratagem. So deadly descent for 1 CP. Add 6 inches to the range of the weapons here. And they're all going to fire at the war boss. So there are 2 inferno pistols, plasma, and 2 regular pistols. So these will hit on 3s. And wound on 5s. So 2 wounds, 2 saving on 4s. Ooh, he takes 2 wounds from the pistols. So with all his warlord traits, he had 7 wounds, he's down to 5. The plasma, overcharged, hits, wounds, doesn't save, down to 3 wounds. And the inferno pistols, hitting on 3s. Wounding on 3s, because it's ridiculous to... Ooh. Saving on 4s. So 2 go through. Now I have a miracle dice of a 4, so I will spend that. And he will fall. So maybe he's wishing he'd been de-jumped now. So the canoness will put her pistol into the knob with war banner, hitting on 2s, re-rolling 1s, wounding on 4s, 2 wounds, saving on 6s. And they're 2 damage apiece. How many wounds does the knob with war banner have? If he's got 5 wounds, he's okay. He's got 4 wounds. So we take him off as well. You've not done much. Oh, he was supposed to give extra attacks or something, right? Oh, well. Need to learn that. And I keep forgetting all the re-wound rolls for these guys. I need to check some ranges then. So the flamers and the melter here are in range of the knobs. The flamer at the back here is not in range, but everything else is. And I must remember the heavy bolt is hitting on fours. But we'll start with the girls here. Two flamers. And the combi melter hits on a four. And the bolters hit on a four. Bolters miss. And a wound on a two. Save on a six. And do... They don't have a small crumb, so I can't... One damage. Putting one knob down to one wound. And two flamers for five. Wounding on fours. Three saving on sixes. Oh! Hang on a minute, and that one has a five up, feel no pain. Nope, and this one has a five up, feel no pain. So it's still down to one wound. So the melt is out of range and the flame is out of range. So there is bolter. So there's three bolter shots hitting on threes and one heavy bolter. So we'll do bolters, wounding on fours. Saving on a six, and then a five or a six. We cannot take these knobs down. Heavy bolter, hitting on fours. Wounding on threes. Two six up saves. Nope. A five up for the first guy. Nope. And then, so he's down. And then a five up on the... The second guy. So there is just one guy left there. And I have run out of gun. And no charging. So he lost three and his leadership seven. And he wants to stay in the fight. Mortal him, I suppose. So the orcs will go a crumping all by himself. As we go on to orcs turn three. Because there's no objective here. Nobody's on that objective there. So no points to the sisters. As it's still 5 points to the orcs, 4 points to the sisters. In a very weird moment of self-preservation, the orc went, I think there's Johnny Gubbins this way. So he's now actually holding that objective. The grunt's holding this objective, and the weird boy's holding this objective. So, that's actually 3 points. And we can't shoot anything, and we can't do anything else. So we will end turn three on a very sour note, I guess, for the orcs. They don't like running away, but there's lots of white, tiny, beaky things screaming weird words that make me head hurt. I want gubbins. So I guess it's now up to turn four for the sisters as we try and hunt some orcs down. So before the sisters scream forward, objective two, that one's already gone. Objective four. Ah, this one goes. So we will go on to the movement phase for the sisters. Slightly confused by the orcs tactics, these girls jumped on to get a point there. And everything else advanced forward, apart from the Seraphim, so they can maybe shoot this guy, charge him. Part of me thinks charging him is the better option because I'm going to outnumber him on the objective. But he will do some cramping back. It's going to be fun. But they have a five-up invul. So we'll do some shooting. So yeah, we'll put some shots into him. Plasma, not of a charge, doesn't hit. The Inferno pistols.
two 6-up saves. And oh my goodness, that's 8, 12, 14. This might not be what the plan was supposed to be. So 5 sixes and one more. No, that orc is very much melted. I probably should have charged him. You never know. Are we lucky? We are actually on the objective. We are actually on the objective. So we do claim that one. So that one knob is a little... It's just his boots smoking. Just there. So we get 2 points. Bring us to 6. So it's 8-6. As the weird boy has to make a decision in turn 4 for the orcs. So the weird boy, hearing the chanting and the praising of the Golden Emperor, he runs over this way and he's got a cunning plan. He's cunning, is this weird boy. He's going to jump the boys over here to saw him down. So on a... Not that. I'm going to play... I normally don't pay command points, but because this is kind of narrative, I want kind of... 7. Yep. That goes off. So yeah, I try and avoid playing command points for rerolls, but I think narratively this makes sense. So that's what we will do. So this little bunch of Gretchen have gone... So they will put all the shots down there. I think rock blasters are just 1, strength 3, pistol 1, 12 inches. Yes. So the 10 Gretchen will put their shots into there, hitting on 4s. Strength 3, so wounding on 3s. Saving on 3s. And they're all saved. This is going to be interesting then. So, end of turn 4. We get 1 more point, putting us up to 9. So, it's a 9-6. So, the sisters do need to keep that objective and take those objectives off. As we go on it depends. Which objective will get removed? 5. Actually, that one. Oh. So there are just 2 objectives left on the table. So the orcs are going to win this one regardless. But we can take them off the table. Because it's 6-9, and I can only score 2. In my last turn, which we will do, but we'll go on. My rolling for miracle dice has been atrocious, apart from this last turn. So, well, that's going to go on the flamer, but they move forward. These girls advanced. I think there should be a 12-inch range of there. They move there. They can't shoot the weird boy, but they will charge him, and they can shoot the grots. These will shoot the grots. The grots will not be here for much longer. Oh yes, the flamers are well within range. So we will start there. So we should use our miracle dice for a 6. And then d6. So that's 11. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11. Wounding on 3s. Two, four, six, eight. Saving on 6s because these are AP dash. 2, 4, 6, 7. 7 of them go. The bolter. 1 hit. Doesn't wound. And then the
Bolters. One, two. So just two in that squad. And then the heavy bolter.
Is that right?
One, two.
Yep. Is the flamer in range? I don't think so. Oh, no, the flamer is definitely in range. And they've got some Mulcrum, so we'll do four shots with the flamer. All wounding. There's only three of them left, right? Oh, two of them save. So there's one Gretchen left. Heavy bolter hits on a four. And then, yeah, the heavy bolter, AP minus one. We'll cut straight through. All the Gretchen are removed. And we'll go straight onto the charge phase. We'll charge over here. That's definitely it. So the Seraphim end their charge well within range there. They don't get a lot of attacks. They get four attacks normally, hitting on fours, wounding on fives. Power swords, hitting on fours. Nothing. Alright, I bet I can't. I don't know how many attacks the weird boy has left. Right, he's weird boy Steph. AP minus one, so we will thankfully ignore that. He hits on threes. And he's strength seven, so he's going to wound on threes. I'm going to save it on a three. And we save it. It would have been D3 damage. And that is the end of turn five for the sisters. We get 2 points, putting us on to eight. And the weird boy cannot fall out of combat. So basically, just to wrap this game up, the sisters get four attacks, hitting on fours, wounding on fives, saving on a six. So he takes a single wound, putting him down to three. And then the power sword, no hits. He gets three attacks back, two hits, wounding on threes, saving on threes. And he does D3 for three. So to save one of the sisters, I need... Nope. So he kills a single Seraphim, opening up an exit, and he will run away as fast as he can, as fast as his little orky legs will carry him, get to a teleporter, or to jump himself away. The orcs have been repelled reasonably convincingly. The orcs hit hard, but the sisters did well to survive. And then they just push forward and push forward. But the orcs technically win 9 points to 8. So good job, orcs. As I said, I've got one more box of boys that I'm slowly converting up. I haven't done the boss knob. And you've got a power claw that's got some... Nid bits on it, so it's a Niddy Power Claw. So all of these boys are getting some kind of addition or customization. So the orcs will grow very, very slowly. But the sisters, I'm still loving them. I'm still forgetting all the rules. I'm looking forward to when I get back to playing just one army and I can focus on the rules for that and not forget stuff. But the sisters... Did they actually lose a full squad? I don't think they did. They've got loss. Each unit has suffered a few casualties here and there, but... Oh, no. There was the Melter girls over there. They did go. They're the boss knob. But they just everything shot him. And, yeah, a little bit of green mist. Weird boy, ironically, being the only one to survive. But he did well with his grot shields. That did, it's because they could have jumped in there and actually shot him before they charged him. But with the grots in that bundle, they couldn't do that. But anyway, thank you very much for watching the Yukaran Sector and humouring me still as I play my Solar Hammer.
having lots of fun, forgetting all the rules. But please do like and subscribe. We're gaining a couple of subscribers every time, and it's so good to see you here. Thank you for supporting if you've got this far and are hearing this. I should probably say at the start of videos, shouldn't I? But please do take care. Tell us about your hobby, and we'll see you in the next video.